Hello everyone, this is Amit. Welcome to another Notepad++ tip. In this video, we'll learn three different ways to make Notepad++ your default program in Windows 10. Now, why do you want to do that? Well, if you're working on a particular file format or extension, for example, TXT file or text file, and if Notepad++ is your go-to text editor, then you would like to open those files in text editor by simply double-clicking it. And so that's what we are going to do in this video. By the way, if you haven't subscribed to my channel, I post new videos every week about Notepad++ tips and tricks to make you a better programmer using this incredibly powerful and free tool. So if you haven't subscribed to my channel, please do so. So let's get started. Now, here I have a text file. And when I double click on it, it actually opens in Notepad, which is Microsoft's text editor, which is very basic. Now, you would like to open that into Notepad++. So there are multiple ways to do it. Some work, some doesn't. And we'll go through that, why some of them doesn't work. All right. And so let me start the very first. I'm going to close Notepad++. And I'm going to go to Start menu and search for Notepad++. Now, I'm assuming that you already have Notepad++ installed in your computer. So once you find that, if you click on one of these options which says Run as Administrator, it is going to open Notepad++ in an administrative mode. All right, so let's click on that. And depending upon the settings, you may get just a notification. So click Yes. All right, so I have open Notepad++ in an administrative mode. And the way in which I know it is right on the top title bar, you can see that it just adds this administrator. So that's how you know that it is in administrator mode. So now go to settings and go to preferences and go to file association. Now you can set file association for many different extensions right from Notepad++, and they have already given a different extension that you can set based upon the types or categories. So for example, if I click on Notepad, you can see you can assign .txt or .log file and some other file. Let's say you are working with something related to C, then there's all sort of text editor extension that are there that you can set default to open in Notepad++. Same with the Java or Fortran, and you can even add your own custom extension. So actually I already done that, so I'm going to remove that. And let's say I have a custom file extension called .chk, right? Maybe check or something else. And so let's say I would like to add that so that it'll always open in Notepad++. So all I have to do is just type the extension. I don't need to type dot or star dot or anything, just type the extension and then click on this arrow key. And so now I have set .chk to be open in Notepad++. All right, let's go to Notepad and I'm going to set this txt file also because that's what we want and set it as a default program. And then I'm going to also open this log file, .log file, and go next and click close. And I'm going to close Notepad++. And let's say I'm going to create another file, a log file. And so let's just test our default settings that we just changed. All right. So I just did text.log. And so if you remember, I set three extensions, right? .chk, .txt, and .log to be open in Notepad++. All right, so let's double click on this. So as you can see, when I open .chk, actually it does open in Notepad++. I'm going to close this and I'll try txt file. Now, even though we set our default to Notepad++, it didn't actually open in Notepad++. So what happened there? And so we'll look into the second and third option to really find out why it didn't work. Let's try with the test.log file. And same thing happened, it didn't open in text editor, our Notepad++ text editor. Now, why did this happen? Now, if you are looking at this video, you might have checked different options and online you will see that number of people have that worked when you set it to admin mode, and some people say it doesn't work. And the real reason why it doesn't work is because if you already have the .txt extension set to some program by Windows, then it may not work. So what do I mean by that? And so for checking that, let's go to Start menu again. And this time, search for default apps. All right, and it should show up right away. And I'm going to open that. And these are the default apps. And if you scroll down, there is an option called Choose Default Apps by File Type. Okay, so let's click on that. Choose Default Apps by File Type. And it, depending upon the computer, it might take just a fraction of time to load all the file types. But this is going to give us the list of all the file extension and what are the application that are assigned to it. So what we are looking for is .txt. Now, if you scroll, it'll take forever. And so I'm going to go on the right-hand side, and it's kind of hard to get this scroll bar. But once you get it, just scroll down till you get .txt file, right? And so it's right here, okay? And if you notice, .txt file is set to open in Notepad. And even though when we open our text editor, Notepad++, and when we set it through admin mode, the file extension, somehow Windows still looks at this. And so in order to change the default program or default text editor as Notepad++, all you have to do is find the extension, click on that, and it should give you Notepad++ as an option. So I'm going to change that. In fact, before I do that, let me move this a little bit, and you will see even how it changes. This is my text file, so I'm going to click on that, and I'm going to change it to Notepad++, and notice that file that we just did it. And if you notice that it changed the extension, and it is set even the icon is changed to Notepad++, and that's how we know that it is set to open in Notepad++. So let's confirm that. So double click on that, and there you go. Now you can open any text file. Let me just create another text file just for an example. So I'm going to open a new file called test.txt or text2, whatever. And if I double click on this, it should open in Notepad++, right? Now, we still need to look for this .log file, right? So let's go and search for .log file. And so I'll just look for .log right here, right? So again, you can see the .log file is set to open in Notepad, and the Notepad++ settings somehow doesn't always kick in. And so that is why I set it this video to three different ways. So we have looked into two different ways. We still have to look one more. By the way, when you open Notepad++ in a regular mode without an admin mode, you don't even have this option. So okay. So here I'm going to look for .log file, click on this, and I'm going to say open that in Notepad++. All right, and close this. And if I open this log file now, you can see that it is opening in Notepad++. All right, so we looked into two different ways to set the default application to set as a Notepad++, right? Now, if you notice so far, if the file extension for a particular file is already set by Windows, this setting from, you know, file association doesn't work properly, or it's at least not very consistent. But if you are opening a new file extension which is not set as default by Windows to some other application, you can, it still works. And so to demonstrate that, let me create another file, and I'm going to give some random extension. Let's say it's called file, I'll call myfile.my. Let's say that's the extension, okay? And I want to set this as a default to open in Notepad++, right? And so again, if you remember, we go to Notepad, search for Notepad++, and then run as administrator, say yes, and then we go to settings, preferences, file association, and now you can see that this dialog is open because we are in admin mode. Go to customize, and I'm going to say just my.my, right? No need to add dot there, click OK. Close, close Notepad++, and now I'm going to double click on this, and you can see it did open in Notepad++. So far we logged into two different ways to do it, right? One is from settings, preferences, and file association, and then we also looked at the default apps and go to choose default apps by file type. Now there is one more way to do it, and for that let me just create another file. Let's say I want to open or create Python or a JavaScript. Let's just pick test. And I want to open this file in Notepad++. Now I just pick any just random file extension. It can be anything. And so all you have to do is, this is the third way to do it, right click on it, and this time click on open with, right? Right click on the file, click open with. And then if the Notepad++ doesn't show up in this list, then you have to look for it. And so click on more apps. And then right here, well, not this one. This is another Notepad++ that I have. But click on look for another app. Before that, check this box, because we would like this kind of files, .js file, to always open in Notepad++, right? So I'm going to click this and click on look for another app. And usually Notepad++ is installed in C, programs files x86, and then there should be Notepad++. And then click on Notepad++, all right? And so what we are just doing is we are setting .js file to always open in Notepad++. So I'm going to click open, and now it is opening in Notepad++. So the way in which I check is I close Notepad++ and double click on this file. And now I can see that is file opened in Notepad++. So again, we learned three different ways to make Notepad++ your default text editor or program in Windows. And we looked into different ways why it doesn't work sometime. And so hopefully this is a useful video for you guys. If you do like this video, or if you learned something new, then please click on the like button. And if you would like to learn more about Notepad++ tips and tricks, make sure that you subscribe to my channel. All right. Thank you very much.